Hey everybody, Notion just released webhook actions in their automations feature, and safe to say we at 9x are super pumped about this. We use webhooks for pretty much everything we automate at 9x. It's also why we have a specific module of our course dedicated entirely to webhooks, and it has been something that in our opinion has definitely been missing in Notion. And now that it's here, it really brings the use cases for Notion databases to a whole nother level. Now, if you're not quite sure exactly what a webhook is, simply put, a webhook is just a way that one app can automatically send some data to another app whenever a specific event occurs. In this video, I'm going to walk you through step by step how you can actually set up webhooks in Notion. I'll give you a demonstration about how you can set it up connecting Notion now to Make to then pretty much connect to any other application you like. And I'll also walk you through a real use case that we've already set up for ourselves at 9x. Now, if you're new to the channel, my name is Jan. I'm one of the co-founders of 9x. At 9x, we train business professionals like you in AI and automation and show you how to use tools like Notion to improve the way you work. If that sounds interesting, please make sure to subscribe to the channel. But right now, let's get into it. So to show you how easy it is to set up webhook actions in Notion, I'm going to be using the Notion database that we use to manage our YouTube video production. So we have a YouTube videos database in Notion where you can see the different videos that we're working on and what their status is. And to access the webhook actions, we just need to head to the top right here where there's this little lightning bolt. And here's where we can manage the different automations in this table. And you can see we've already got some automations set up. So what we use a lot are automations that will basically send alerts to Slack. In our case here on the YouTube video database, whenever the status is changing, we're sharing Slack messages so the rest of the team know what we're up to. But what happens if, for instance, you don't want to send it to Slack, but maybe we want to do something with another tool that is currently not integrated with Notion? So in our case, maybe what I want to set up is whenever a video gets moved to recorded, maybe I want to automatically create the Google Drive where we can store all of those raw video files. So to access the webhooks, what I'm going to do is click New Automation. And now I need to select my trigger. First of all, I'm going to give my automation a name. So I'm going to say video recorded webhook. And my trigger is going to be, again, whenever a particular property is edited. In our case, it's going to be the status. So whenever the status is set to recorded, so I only want recorded, now I can select my action. And now for the first time, we have this new action here, which is send webhook. So as you can see, the inbuilt ones are sending an email via Gmail or a Slack message, but this send webhook is going to allow us to basically connect Notion with any application in the internet. So I'm going to click send webhook. And now we have a couple of different options. So first thing we need to enter is what's known as a URL. So this is going to be the URL where our webhook is going to be sent to. And then we can also select which particular properties in my table do I want to send along with this webhook. And in my case, I'm just going to select all existing properties. And now for the URL, what I'm going to be doing in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Make. And Make is an integration platform that integrates with thousands of different apps. If you're also maybe a Zapier user, this will work the exact same way. So I'm going to head over to Make now and grab my webhook URL. So here I am in my Make account. You can see we have a bunch of Make scenarios. If you are a new Make user, we actually have a link in the description below where you can get 1 month free on the pro plan, which will give you 10,000 operations to play with. So more than enough to set up your first Notion webhook actions. I'm just going to hit create a new scenario in the top right here and get started by giving this one a name. So in my case, it might be, I'm just going to call it Notion webhook demo. And now we need to hit this plus button and set up the trigger of our Make scenario. And all I need to search for is webhooks. So webhooks, the name in Make, and it's also the name in Notion, very easy to remember. And what I want to do is set up a custom webhook. Triggers when this webhook receives data. And what we need to do is create a new webhook. And I'll give this one a name, Notion YouTube video marked as recorded. So these names are going to be useful because in the end, you'll always be able to keep track of which webhooks you've created. I'll save this one. And what Make now does is it has generated a specific link for us. And this is the URL of the webhook. Whenever this URL receives data, this Make automation can now run. So let me copy this address. What Make is doing, it's actually listening and waiting first to, basically you need to send it a test request so it knows what type of data it can expect. So let me copy this one and I'll head back over to Notion. And in my Notion, all I need to do is paste that link in the URL field. I'm saying I want to send all the properties. And so all I need to do now is create. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick one of these videos down here and mark it as recorded. And now we need to head back over to Make and see if it has basically caught the webhook. And here we see that this is now changed and saying, hey, we've successfully determined that test that you sent just worked. Now, this is not so great for visibility to see what type of data was sent. So what I like doing is I'm just gonna hit save and run this one more time. And now you can see again, it's listening and waiting for some data to be sent to this webhook. Back in Notion, I'm just gonna find that same video, mark it back as in preparation and again as recorded. So my automation should now run again. And in Make, we see that that data has now come in, and now we can basically look into what type of data we're receiving from these Notion webhooks. So first of all, we have this little source collection. So what we can see in here that it's giving us some information about what actually triggered this webhook. Not probably so useful for us just business operators, but let's have a look in the data side. So we can see now a few interesting things. We're saying, hey, that this automation was triggered by a page, and we have the ID of that page. We have the parent, which is a saying that, hey, this is coming from a page in a database. And we also get the ID of which database it is. But probably the most interesting here is in this little properties collection. And here we see all the properties in the table. And this is going to be the contain the specific values of that video that just got marked as recorded. So if we take a look, let's see here on the video title, we can see here in the title, there is the plain text title, Notion Automations Webhook Actions. We can see the owner. Let's have a look at the status. So the status is now recorded. We have a bunch of other things like the priority of the video, when the publish, when the due date. And what's great now is all of these data points that we have from our table can now be used in any other app. So as I said, Make allows you to connect to thousands of different applications. I could now send this information to Google Sheets if I wanted to. As I mentioned in the example, is maybe we want to create a Google Drive. So I can just go here and create a Google Drive folder, use the name of the YouTube video that we're getting from the Notion webhook. And then I could even save the link of the Google Drive folder back into Notion. Really, the possibilities are endless. And as I promised at the start of the video, I'm now going to show you a real use case that we've already set up for ourselves at 9X. So now I want to walk you through an automation with webhooks that we've already set up and are using at 9X. So we also, apart from recording YouTube videos, we also regularly run live events and we do these live workshops, and where they are basically set up on Eventbrite, where people can register on Eventbrite. We then have the live session on Zoom. And afterwards, what we want to do is share a recording with everyone that attended the event. And we're basically managing all these live events here in Notion with a calendar database. So here you can see some of the last workshops that we've ran. We have a column with the Eventbrite ID, a column where we're going to put the Zoom recording link. And what I've basically done is I've added some, basically a single select field. And this is going to be a very useful trick I would recommend when you're doing automations. So what I've done here is we have this shared, and I have to be careful what I select here. So we have this 9X Live share recording property here in Notion. And you'll see there is one field that's called trigger. So what this does is whenever we have completed an event, so for the next one that happens next week, I just need to put in the event ID and this recording link, and then basically say to trigger this email. And what this will do is I have an automation here that says send 9X Live recording email. And so what this one does is whenever this single select field gets changed to trigger, the first thing we do is we change this and mark it to in progress. And you might be wondering, like, why are you already changing this? This is very useful because whenever you're working with webhooks and external application, sometimes things fail and they don't go the way you want. And if it hasn't like completed the action, it's then good to know is like of the ones you triggered, if you see an hour later that it's still in progress, you probably know that maybe something has gone wrong with your automation. I'm again just using a make URL, and here I'm telling it to send all of the fields of this calendar database. So now here I am in make, and this is the, as I said, the scenario that is running here. You've seen a scenario that has ran when I changed a previous event to trigger. Let's first take a look. You can see here the different data, so the different properties. We have our event name, which is here in the title. So we see this was the prompt engineering for beginners event. We have the Eventbrite ID, so you can see here that number, and we have all the other fields here, and you can see the share live recording was set to in progress. And so what I'm doing here in my make scenario is a few different things. The first branch, so if I go back over to Notion, you'll see here that I have basically this checkbox field that says 9x live recording sent. Basically, I've set this up, so this is sort of like a double check to make sure that we don't accidentally trigger the same email twice. So what you'll see later is after an email is successfully sent of the recording to all the participants, I basically in make update this field and say, hey, the email has been sent. In make, what I'm doing in this first path is basically checking whether the live X recording is equal to true. If it's equal to true, all I'm gonna do is in Notion, basically update the field to say, hey, it's already been sent this email and I don't wanna trigger any emails. Likewise, I have another path here that basically checks what are all the required fields I need in my email. So I need to know the Eventbrite ID, I need to know the Zoom recording link, and I also need to know the title, for instance. If any of those fields are missing, I'm going to run this Notion step, which is just gonna update that same field. So if we don't have the required fields, I'm in my make scenario setting this one to failed. Now we have the last path here. This is the path saying, hey, if we have all the right information and the email hasn't been sent, I'm doing a few first steps to Eventbrite. So first of all, I do one call to Eventbrite to get all the information about the event that we just ran. And this is basically using the event ID. So based on the event ID that we have in Notion, I want you to get me all the details from the Eventbrite. So we can see the summary, we can see the title, and we can use that all in our email. Then what I'm doing is I'm using here a little action from Eventbrite that says list orders. So based on the event ID, I want you to show me every single person here that basically attended the event. And you can see in the last event, we had quite a good attendance. So there were 157 people that placed a ticket. And now for all of these 157, what I want to do is send them an email with the recording. And here we're using customer.io to do this. After all those emails have been sent, I'm using, and because you can see in Make, if you get into Make a little bit more, Make have this concept known as bundles. And as you can see here, there is one bundle for every single person that signed up to our event, which means for all of these bundles, the next step will happen once for each bundle. So every single person gets their own email sent to them with the recording. And then what we need to do is basically aggregate all those 157 bundles back into one. And finally, then once all of this is aggregated, I'm just using one call to Notion and setting basically the share recording single select to email sent and checking that checkbox as ticked. We can have a look here. You can see here on the property values, I've basically set the 9x live recording sent equals true. This was previously empty. And the 9x live share recording single select has now been changed to email sent. So I hope this gave you a little bit of inspiration to see just what is possible now that Notion has released its Webhook Actions feature. So that's it for this quick tutorial on Notion Webhooks. I hope you found it useful. If you still have some questions, definitely drop them in the comments below. Also, I'm very interested, how do you plan to use this? What are you planning to build with these Notion Webhooks? Let me know in the comments. Now, if you did find this video useful, it would mean a lot if you could like and subscribe. And until next time, happy automating.